hidden in the trails, just outside of Milford, surrounded by cedar trees. You can find a historic gem, but you basically got to be right on top of it before you even know it's right in front of you.
There's always a surprise. Everywhere you turn, there's something you didn't see the time before. And I mean, just like today, I've had a chance to come out, see something I've never seen before. And so I've lived here quite a while and never had the opportunity to come out here. And you'll never know what you run into.
Massive kilns. When you first come upon them, you may not know just what you're looking at. They look like some kind of ancient pyramids or prehistoric ruins. In actuality, though, they're structures that were a critical part of the mining history in the Beaver area.
There was a bunch of charcoal and coal, so I think that they burned wood in there and did some with the coals.
Not far off, Dallin. The kilns were used to burn coal to create a fuel known as coke. Coke is a hard, porous fuel, and it's vital in the production of steel and smelting iron. These kilns specifically made coke that was used to smelt metals at the mines of Frisco and Newhouse.
They looked kind of like houses, but had big old holes in the roof, and they had like a window.
The kiln masters who built these back in the day specifically left ventilation holes in the rocks so the air would come in and rise out, allowing them to perfect the process needed to make coke. The coals would burn inside the structures, and the vents could be sealed as needed. The coke could be left to cool for up to a week before being shipped off to the mines. But you should keep in mind that while these pristine and unique historical artifacts might be what draws you to the area, they are certainly not the only place that you'll want to enjoy on your next visit.
The thing I love most about out here is it's remote, it's big country. When you get up on some of these bigger peaks where you can look around and just appreciate how big and wide open it is, it's incredible. So up in the Tushers, you've got the high alpine forest that you'll see on any of your best ranges in the western U.S. We have it right here up on the Tusher Mountains. I grew up reading stories about the mountain man and wishing I could go visit the Rocky Mountains. And then I realized I live in the middle of it. Just have to get up and see it.
And when you take a ride up in the Tusher Mountains, everyone in the family is sure to have a great time.
The biggest rewards of getting in the hills is the time with the family. And you can come out and be in the exact same place you've gone 100 times and find something different every time you come. That's the beauty of nature. It's different every time you see it.
I mean, get to go out, explore, and just see new things.
If you're lucky, you might just get to catch a glimpse of some of the local wildlife.
Pretty cool. I don't think I've ever seen that much mustangs in one area.
And as a member of the search and rescue, David insists that if you come out to explore the area, you've got to remember to come prepared.
So if you're going to come out here, make sure you get familiar with the map first, because it is such big country and there's so many little side roads everywhere. And of course, always make sure you have a plan, let someone know where you're gonna be, when you're gonna be back. And then when you're out here, have lots of water. You know, today's a pretty cool day, relatively speaking, and it's hot. Have some extra gear with you in case you do get lost or get where you can't get out. It's a beautiful place. You can find anything you wanna see in Beaver County.
As always, you are gonna have a great time. For At Your Leisure, at the Beehive Kilns at Frisco, I'm Joe Davis.